This video will cover how to represent culverts in an SRH-2D model using the SMS user interface. A user can represent any type of culvert within SMS. There are multiple ways to represent culverts within SMS. A user can either choose to represent the culvert using an embedded 1D model approach or as a 2D feature within the SMS mesh. The type of culvert and the focus of the culvert in the model are important factors in deciding which method to use to represent the culvert. This video will discuss the importance of these factors and the key modeling concepts to implement when representing culverts in SMS. The two factors the modeler should take into consideration before representing a culvert in SMS are 1. The role of the culvert in the model, and 2. The shape of the culvert in the model. The role of the culvert in your model is an important consideration for representation. Whether the culvert is a primary hydraulic feature that is key to the results at the area of focus, or a secondary feature that will not be a major factor to the results should be considered. The user can choose a more detailed approach to represent the culvert if it is a primary feature, or conversely, simplify the modeling approach if the culvert is not a primary focus of the model. The shape and size of the culvert are also important consideration for culvert representation. Using the 1D embedded option, the user can input any known shape of culvert using the HY8 interface. However, when representing the culvert as a 2D feature, the user is limited to box and simple arch-shaped culverts using either pressure flow boundaries or the newer 3D bridge feature. Circular and relatively small culverts are better represented using the 1D embedded approach. To represent the culvert as a 1D feature, the user will first create two boundary condition arcs corresponding to end locations of the barrel. The arcs should both be drawn in the same direction. If using the 1D model to account for overtopping, the arc length should closely match the overtopping length. If using the 2D mesh to account for overtopping, the arc length should closely match the span of the barrel, or in some instances, the widest length between the culvert wing walls. The terrain elevations at the arc locations should represent the corresponding elevations near the upstream and downstream locations of your barrel. It is recommended that the elements between your arcs be composed of near orthogonal quadrilateral elements. Doing so will help better define the disabled area between the arcs and will result in better computational stability. Next, the boundary condition arc types will need to be assigned by selecting both lines and setting the BC type to culvert HY8. There is also a culvert BC type, which is an internal culvert calculation within SMS. However, this is only included for backwards compatibility for older model simulations. For all new simulations, the culvert HY8 BC type is the recommended BC type for the 1D embedded approach. Choosing the culvert HY8 option, there are some initial inputs and settings the user will need to enter and or consider. First, ensure the arcs are assigned appropriately. This can be done by reviewing the arc IDs for the upstream and downstream locations. Next, the proper units for the model should be selected. HY8 handles both English and metric units. Next, there are two checkboxes to consider. The first is whether to use total head, which considers velocity plus water surface elevation. The user should consider this checkbox if the culvert is highly aligned to flow in the model, and especially if the culvert consists of large barrels and is performing more like a bridge than a culvert. The equations used to develop HY8 were based on static head elevation to drive flow through the culvert, and using this checkbox accounts for momentum and better approximates true flow through the culvert. In the second checkbox, the user can choose whether to use 2D terrain for overtopping or have it to be all calculated internally in HY8. With the checkbox on, the boundary arcs are treated as links in the model, meaning the calculated culvert flow capacity is simply removed from the upstream arc and returned at the downstream arc. The elements between the arcs are active with this approach, and any excess flow will utilize the area between them. Using this method, the shape of the elements between the arcs is not important for model calculations. In general, when using this checkbox, it is recommended to check resulting flow patterns and continuity, as it has been known to introduce instabilities in some cases. With all settings and arcs appropriately selected, click Launch HY8. From here, the user is directed to the typical H-way user interface. For help on general H-way use and questions regarding internal calculations, refer to the help menu within H-way 8. This is not the focus of this video, so not a lot of time will be spent on using H-way 8. To edit the culvert crossing data, double-click or right-click on the appropriate crossing. The user should name each crossing or culvert appropriately. Note that you can have multiple culverts per crossing. In the crossing data window, the discharge and tailwater inputs will be taken directly from the 2D model. However, the roadway, culvert, and site data will all be entered manually. Most inputs are normal to HY8. However, there are a few that require special consideration due to the interaction with SRH-2D. First, if you choose to represent overtopping in the 2D mesh, it is currently the best practice to set the overtopping width in HY8 to 0.1 feet. This allows for minimal overtopping flow within HY8 and forces the 2D mesh to handle the bulk of the overtopping flows. Second, if the bounding terrain elevations are higher than the elevations entered in the site data tab, then it can impede flow into the barrel and cause model instabilities. Ensure that the inverts entered in the site tab are representative of the culvert and that the terrain elevations in the model are set appropriately. Click OK once all data has been entered, then save and close HY8 to return to the assigned BC window. From here, the user will need to select the correct crossing that was set up using the HY8 interface. The culvert is now ready for modeling using the 1D embedded approach. To represent a culvert as a 2D feature within SMS mesh, the user will model the culvert much like modeling a bridge. The base of the culvert will be built into the 2D mesh and the top of the culvert will be represented as a pressure flow bridge. There are two possible methods to consider. The first method uses standard pressure flow boundary arcs to define the geometry. The second method uses the 3D bridge tool to define ceiling elevations. For the purposes of this video, only the standard pressure flow method will be covered. For more information on the 3D bridge tool, please refer to the SMS wiki page, the workflows, tutorials, and videos. Using the standard pressure scenario, the user will first create two boundary condition arcs corresponding to end locations of the barrel. The length of the arcs should closely match the span of the barrel and also be drawn in the same direction. Once both bounding arcs are drawn, the user will select both arcs and assign the boundary condition type to pressure. In the Assign BC window, ensure both arcs are assigned properly and fill out the rest of the required data. There are two options for ceiling type, flat or parabolic. The flat option can be used for standard box culverts, while parabolic can be used for simple arch shapes. For more complex shape culverts, the user can either enter multiple pressure flow boundaries or use the 3D bridge tool. If the box model for overtopping on this zone is checked, the user will be able to enter a crest elevation, length, and road type. Here, the user can also specify to use total head as compared to using only the water surface elevation in the weir flow calculations used for overtopping. Next, the user will need to build the bottom of the barrel into the mesh and use corresponding element roughness values and elevations. The best practice is to use orthogonal quadrilateral elements to represent the elements bounded by the pressure flow arcs. Additionally, quadrilateral elements should be used upstream and downstream of the pressure flow zone to assist the flow transition when pressure flow is active. To represent the sidewalls, it is recommended that the user create holes in the mesh to transition the gap from the bottom of the culvert to the top of the embankment. Some caution should be taken if overtopping flow is not aligned to the barrel, as the holes will impede transverse flow. The culvert is now ready to model using the 2D feature approach. Here are some final considerations for culvert representation in SMS. BC data lines. In the assigned BC window for both 1D hydraulic structures and bridge pressure flow internal boundary conditions, there are options to use BC data lines. BC data lines should be considered if a user has set up a variable boundary condition, there is high skew at the structure, or there is rapid drawdown at the entry point or exit of the structure. More information about using BC data lines can be found on the SMS wiki page. Viewing results. Viewing results for 1D, embedded, and 2D approaches can be done via observation lines. No results will be shown to the culvert using the 1D embedded approach, but they will be shown using the 2D approach. The structure itself can be represented using plot data coverage. Compared to the output windows that HY8 typically gives, this SRH-2D culvert output is limited. However, if more detailed results are necessary, the user can use the results of the 2D model to inform a separate H-weight analysis. Thank you for watching this video on representing culverts in an SRH-2D model. For more general guidance, tutorials, and videos, please visit the links provided below in the description.